Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Amanda and today we are going to be doing my April wrap-up. So for the month of April, I got to the end of it and I was looking back in my journal on all the books that I read and DNF'd this month, and I noticed that every single book in here either has a video that I have currently filmed and is up on my channel or is going to be on my channel by the end of May. I realized that doing a wrap-up is absolutely pointless because I talk about every single one of these books in a different video. But I made a promise to myself at the beginning of the year when I started my BookTube channel that at least for the first year I was going to do a wrap-up and a TBR every single month so I could look back on my progress and see what I had read and what I thought about those books and all that jazz. So I don't want to disappoint, but I also don't want to bring you guys a pointless video. So I thought to myself, I could talk about the fifth Harry Potter, which I haven't talked about yet on my channel, but there's two issues with that. One, I'm trying to save talking about all of the Harry Potter books for their own video, and two, I haven't actually started this one yet. I was supposed to read this one in the month of April, and it is April 27th, so I have 3 more days to start, read, and finish it, but it's 870 pages, so I'm not totally sure I'm going to be able to accomplish all of that. Second thing I thought about doing to add more to this video was I could do my haul, because I just ordered some books online and I thought it would be really nice to show you all what I ordered, but not all of them have shown up. In fact, only 2 of them have shown up as of this moment, so that's not really an exciting haul video. But then it hit me, something that I could talk about with you guys is I last month set a goal for myself to try to read all of the books on my physical TBR so that by the end of the year I only had one left and it wasn't any of the ones I currently own. So that meant I could buy new books for my physical TBR as long as I read equal to or more of than what I'm putting onto my physical TBR. There's gonna be a lot of ifs, buts, and ands with that that you'll see later in the video. So I have my tea and I have my journal and I can talk to you guys about all the books that I read in April. So starting out on the 1st, I did manage to read The Hunger Games, which was a reread, and it was my reread for this month. I did end up reading Catching Fire and Mockingjay. The first two I rated 5 out of 5 stars. The third one I had originally rated 3 out of 5 stars, and I ended up rating it 4 out of 5 stars the second time reading it. You can watch that video, it'll be coming out sometime in May. It'll be something titled like The Hunger Games Marathon or rereading The Hunger Games or partaking in all media from The Hunger Games. And all 3 of those were for the Owls Challenge. Now I'm going to quickly run through all of the books that I read for the Owls Challenge on top of those ones. As of right now, I've officially read 11 books for the Owls Challenge, which is where I'd left you at the end of my last vlog, and I was planning on reading the fifth Harry Potter for the 12th prompt. As of right now, I haven't done it, but I do fully plan on finishing it before the end of the month. So let's just say that I have read 12 books for the Owls Challenge and I have read many, many pages, close to 4,000 pages. I think I'm just over 4,000 pages. Continuing on, the next book that I read for the Owls Challenge was The 12 Kings of Sharakai, and I ended up rating that book 3 out of 5 stars, but the more I'm thinking about it, I might lower that rating. The next book I read was The Name of the Wind, which I ended up rating 5 out of 5. Absolutely loved it. After that, I read Beneath the Sugar Sky, which I rated 3.75 out of 5 stars. After that, I DNF'd The Lies of Locke Lamora. Didn't like it, wasn't interested in it. After that, I read The Most Dangerous Game, which I ended up rating 2 out of 5 stars, and upon starting it, I realized it was a reread, that I had already read it in the past. It's still too hot. After that, I did read The Curse of the Healing Kiss. I said that I had read it, but I later decided to go back and change it to a DNF because most of the reading had been skimming, and for me, I don't really count that as actually reading a book. I like to have all the books I've read as actual books I have read, and one of the chapters I like barely read, so I'm counting it as a DNF and not an actual read. Next book I read was Aurora Rising, which I rated 5 out of 5 stars. I reread this in preparation for next month reading Aurora Burning. After that, I read The Crier's War, which I rated 3 out of 5 stars. It was absolutely okay. After that, I read And the Ocean Was Our Sky, which I also am going to change from a reading status to a DNF status because I skimmed more of that book than I read it. I think that's where it comes down to, is if I skim less than 50%, I'm okay with counting it as read, but if I skim more than 50%, then I personally would like to change it to DNF. You will also be able to find that book not only in my Owls Readathon, but I'll be posting a book called Highs and Lows in May, very early in May. It should be one of the first videos I post, and you can find out more about that book then. And so that was it for all the books that I read for the Owls. So I know that technically that means that since I'm changing two of the books from read status to DNF status, I've only technically read 10, but I can't like go back and take off from the Hogwarts Owls Google Drive. Like, I can't edit it. I can only post to it. And I had already posted to them when I was counting them. So unfortunately, they're there. So I'm going to count them towards the Owls Reading Challenge, but just not towards my Goodreads goal of books that I'm trying to read this year. The next books that I'm going to be talking about have all different videos, so I will let you know what videos they'll be posted in as I talk about them. So the next book I'm going to be talking about is A Memory Called Empire, and I did a whole video on this. I rated it 5 out of 5 stars. It's a new personal favorite. You can find it labeled something like A Memory Called Empire book review. After that, I read Age of Myth, which will also be in the Highs and Lows video. You can go check that out early May. I absolutely loved it. I rated it 5 out of 5 stars. After that, I DNF'd a book called The Madman's Daughter. That'll be coming out in a video that I'm not going to tell you the title of right now, but it is based off of something that I saw on Books and Lala's channel recently, and I'm really excited to be bringing you that video. Along with that, I also read A Girl of Fire and Thorns. I will talk about all of that in that video. And then finally, I read The Memory Thief, which I ended up rating 2 out of 5 stars. In the video, I rated it 2.5 out of 5 stars, but as time has passed, I've also changed my rating for that. You can watch that book in the video titled, I Read the Lowest Rated Book on My Shelf. So those are all of the books I read in April. Looking at my TBR for April, I ended up DNFing or sampling a few books that I had on my TBR and then didn't enjoy them, so I quit them. If I'm only sampling the book, I don't count it as a DNF. I ended up doing that to 5 books on my TBR. Other than that, there were 6 books that I did not get to this month that I had wanted to get to, but I read other books in place of those. I ran into the problem where I had originally set my TBR before I realized I was going to do the Owl, so I had to change some things last minute. Next month, I am hoping to get to some of those ones that I missed, and I'll talk about all of that in that video. So now I'm going to talk to you guys about my physical TBR and what the hell happened to it this month. So last month, I already quickly told you that I wanted to have less books on it by the end. I want to basically be going down at least one each month, because at the time I had 9 books on my physical TBR, and I would like to read one a month, because as of last month, there were 9 months left in the year. At that point, I was not including any electronic books or any audiobooks, because I get through those really quickly and I'm not worried about those. And then I also wasn't including any pre-orders. If you go onto my Goodreads bookshelf, I do include all of those in my owned but not read bookshelf, but I don't include them in this number count that I'm talking to you guys about right now. So last month, my owned but not read shelf said 21, which isn't too horribly bad, I guess, because I wasn't counting some of those books. There's only 9 that I actually needed to read every single month. But as of right now, the shelf says 28, and that panics me, because how the hell did it go up that much? Out of those, there are only 12 books on my physical TBR, paperbacks, hardbacks, whatever, that I need to get to before the end of the year. So I did end up reading 2 books off of that list. I read The 12 Kings of Shara Kai, and I read The Name of the Wind. I read more than one last month, which is awesome, but then I also went up in numbers. And I feel like I should have some kind of punishment for myself. But also, I don't work very well off of like a punishment and reward system, because I know I will make up all of these books that I've bought before the end of the year, because I guess the overall punishment is if I don't, I have to get rid of the books, because if they've been sitting on my shelf that long, I'm not gonna get to them. I'm not gonna read them. I'm sorry. There are a few on the shelf that I am considering DNFing, and they're the ones that have been on my shelf the longest. But I don't want to do that without at least trying them. Really, all that's changed is I have more books in the shelf, which means I now need to read about 2 every single month instead of 1 every single month. And I will get to talking about which ones I'm going to be reading in my May TBR, which will be coming out in 2 to 3 days. I am also planning on doing a video every single other day of May. So every odd day, you can expect to see a video from me posted on my BookTube channel. I'm really, really excited about that. Also, other exciting news, I did start a Bookstagram account and I am trying to post every day as of right now. So that's it for this video. Hopefully it wasn't as pointless as I felt like it was going to be. Yeah, I guess it was just more of a check-in and a chat and a talk with you guys. Let me know if you've read any of these books down below. I'd love to hear from you and I'd love to talk about them with you. I don't remember how my outro goes. So until next time, I will talk to you guys in the comments. Bye.